Okay, halo-halo teman-teman, guys, saudara-saudara semuanya. Selamat datang kembali di channel Clever Nilai. Sekarang aku main game. Ini judulnya The Life and Suffering of Sir Brante. In times of the fall of the blessed Arknian Empire. Oh, panjang banget. Ini game ini ya, game visual novel, game adventure RPG tapi visual novel. Soalnya aku senang sih game-game visual novel, biasanya tuh dia tuh bergantung kepada pilihan apa yang kita pilih. Jadi endingnya bisa banyak kepada konsekuensi yang kita pilih. Jadi mungkin apa yang kita pilih akan membuat jalan ceritanya menjadi berbeda. Tergantung pemain. Jadi membuat apa ya, penasaran lah. Oke, langsung aja deh, new game. Sir siapa ya? S Brante. Consequences, udah konsekuensinya lagi gila. Duh, kalau konsekuensinya diliatin gak seru dong. Hidden, tapi restartnya di enable, jadi supaya bisa restart. Nah, konsekuensinya jangan diliatin, tapi boleh di restart. Oke, kita start langsung. Oh, before you lies, ada teman-teman langsung baca aja deh. Ini jadi game casual novel, game choose akan mempengaruhi jalan cerita. At the end of time, your fingers are stained with ink, your breathing grows weak, your hands are shaking. Yet the words begin appearing on the page before you, one by one, clinging together to form a chronicle of your own life. Who are you, and how did you reach this end? You were born, raised, and lived your entire life in the blessed Arknian Empire. In this land, man's destiny is predetermined at the moment of his birth. Whether human or Arknian, nobleman, priest, or lowborn commoner, all bend to the divine will of the twin gods. And each life is knocked by a single cog in the universe's immeasurable machine. The memories come flooding back. They engulf you as merciless wave, binding together days that are trees dead and gone. The dreams of your childhood, your adolescence, your youth spent in the capital, years of peace teeming with life and a war drenched in blood, high rents and lowly deeds, opulent palaces, secretive city backstreet, fields of battle, and faces, so many faces of the people you held dear. The people who walk this road by your side. Such was your life, now exposed by ink, erupting onto the page. With your every step, you sought to change the world as you saw fit. The choice of your upbringing, the path you carved in your youth, the fruits of your struggle, the consequences of your sacrifice, all of it led you to here, to the end of your time, and every choice at a price. Now, years and years later, the crossroads of your life echo in your memory. The pain and joy inextricably intermingle. Aduh, ini bahasa Inggrisnya udah yang Ngeri nih. Could you have taken a different path, chosen a different calling, found a different place in the world? You had the power to alter the very course of history. Udah pilih, wah udah, kita udah milih nih. What determine a man's destiny? Destiny is no destiny. There is no destiny. Gak ada takdir. Higher, kekuatan tertinggi. Your path was charted for you by the people, the age, and the society in which you live. The man himself. You made your own destiny. Jadi apa yang mungkin maksudnya tuh, sekarang kita memilih apa yang bisa menentukan sebuah takdir, sebuah takdir lagi. Apa yang bisa menentukan takdir sebuah manusia? Ini ada manusianya sendiri, ada dunia yang mengelilinginya, kekuatan tertinggi, dan atau tidak ada takdir. Kita sendiri sih, dunia nyata juga. The man himself dong. Your life has always been yours to live. You made your own destiny. Inilah the man himself. Apa nih? At the end of time, you can hear that footstep drawing near. You square your shoulder and take a deep full breath. You have found your final answer. What is destiny other than a long chain of your own action and decisions? No matter what happened in your life, you always had a choice. You live the life you deserve. Only you can answer for it. Apa nih? On this page, a story a man named S. Brantley will live once more. Okay, continue. Childhood, masa kecil. Continue. Oh, jadi chapter pertama tuh kita ketika kita anak-anak. Okay, boleh. Setting. Oke, jadi tahun 1100. Waduh. Tahun 1100. Waduh. Memang jadul. Bukan jadul lagi sih, ini udah, wow, udah berabad-abad yang lalu ini. Keren-keren. Chapter pertama, childhood, masa kecil. Oke, masa kecil kita gimana? Childhood. Where life begins, first words, first unsteady steps. You are but a small child, learning about the world in which you were born. To you, everything is so new, so baffling, and so unforgiving. A long, trying life stretched before you, so many fits and falls, so many fateful choices to come. Yet you are already sowing the seeds of your future self. You are learning to live and survive in this world, looking for a place within it to call your own, choosing your future destiny. Who will you grow up to be? Okay, wah, keren-keren nih. Will, jadi kita masa kecil kita tuh apa ya? Aduh, istilahnya kalau who will you grow up to be itu, jadi masa kecil kita tuh terkenang dengan apa gitu. Kita seringnya tuh bertemu dengan sesuatu seperti apa gitu. Nah, di sini tuh ada maksudnya masa kecil kita tuh sesuatu yang penting tuh ketika kita masih kecil tuh apa gitu. Di sini ada pelajaran tentang fencing. Oh, mengalami apa ya, tragedi antara kematian dan kehidupan. Wah, duh, edan juga nih, kita masih kecil udah langsung mengalami kematian pertama kita. Wow. Insight. masa itu. Jadi pengalaman kita melihat, oh pengalaman, when your mother tells you about the ways the world and the lots of its inhabitants, insight itu dimana orang tua kita mengajarkan cara dunia dan cara kehidupan berjalan gitu. Bagaimana kehidupan berjalan, bagaimana dunia berjalan, apa aja yang terjadi, bagaimana cara makhluk hidup bertahan, lingkungan bertahan. Ini insight ya. Ini nobleman, sacrament. You challenge the sacred order and attempt to seize the noble lord. Kalau ini nobleman sacrament tuh, jadi kita melanggar sebuah, wah, melanggar sebuah perintah yang sakral. Terus kita banyak to seize, apa ya, banyak seize tuh kayaknya menangkap, oh, bukan menangkap ya. Jadi kita melakukan hal-hal, maksudnya melakukan hal-hal noble lah, hal-hal yang, aduh, istilahnya apa ya? Loh, teman-teman lebih tahu deh. Jadi melakukan hal-hal apa ya? Hal-hal yang noble tuh maksudnya hal-hal yang terhormat gitu maksudnya. You challenge the sacred order and attempt to seize a noble lord. Nah, di sini tuh ada statusnya. Kalau milih fencing lesson ada dapat determination 4. Train with father. Nah, kalau beyond suffer your first death. Inside dapat status perception. Kalau ini dapat willpower 5, kiss the sword. Aduh, milih yang mana nih? Fencing lesson. Ini pasti dari determination, perception, willpower. Masa kecil aku sih ini lebih bagus perception nih. Condition. Oh, ini keren juga nih. Suffer your first death. Dapat status determination. Fencing lesson aja deh. Belum bisa nih. Oh, belum bisa milih. Ya ampun, kirain milih nih. Oh, your personal qualities at this age. Determine which choice. Tapi bisa dipilih nih. Willpower. The section that opened in this chapter. Destiny screen, personality screen, House of Brante screen, family screen. Begin chapter. Ya ampun, kirain tadi milih. Ya udahlah, kita begin aja deh. Bird. At first there's nothing, no time, no sensation, nothing but darkness and void. Oke. Waduh, kita lahir nih. It was your turn to enter this world. Your first memory, you are lying on your back, blinded by a bright white light. You are not alone. Above you tower the colossal figure of those who created you. There are two of them, the ones who made you form from their own self and brought you into this world. They are united. Yet as they lean closer, you begin to see how different they are. The first figure is so empathetic, wise, and merciful. The love that emanates from you wraps you head to toe like an invisible blanket. The second figure is strong and powerful, commanding and noble. Nah, ini bapak dan ibu sih. Yet there is a third figure, like a shadow, barely seen behind them. You already, yet already pushing with unbreakable will to live. A self-open palm, a strong closed fist, and a lingering distant shadow. Reach out the palm, the fist, smile at the shadow. Smile at the shadow. Kita tersenyum kepada bayangan. Wah. Your first smile appears on your face, awkward yet genuine. Your mother, father exchange looks and start talking. But the stranger behind them has no need for words. Okay. The shadow brings finger to its lips as to say, "There, there, baby, don't cry. This is our secret now." Okay, continue. Oh, dapat willpower. Powernya naik nih. Your life in this world begin. How will you live? Tahun 1118. Okay, childhood. Hide and seek. You recognize father by his heavy breath and strong cold hands. He visits you rarely. Oh, nama bapaknya ini Robert Bronte. Hello there, little ass Bronte. Mother tender voice, however, follows you day and night. Oh, Lydia Bronte. My, you are growing so quickly, my child. There are two more children in the family named Stephen and Gloria. Gloria sings song to you. She often dresses you in tight clothing and gently holds your hand as you learn to take your first steps. Stephen likes to sweep you up and pinch you and toss you into the air. Oh, look, this is your brother and sister. Yeah, you are my little brother. We are gonna play together. But I always be in charge because you were born a commoner. Be quiet, you. You don't understand yet. Come on, baby ass. Let's go play in the yard. Again, six. Itu main petak umpet ini. Aduh. Why are you staring at the shining pillar? It's not going anywhere, you know? Hey, I wanna play hide and seek. He just little baby. How is gonna play? Then you hide him and I try to find both of you. Bukan main petak umpet. Stephen and Gloria glance each other. Then your brother walks to big tree, close his eyes and start shooting something. Gloria take your hand and walks you through the yard. Your sister take you behind some thick bushes by a tall wall. Gloria sits you down on the ground and puts a finger to her mouth for some reason, and then she's gone. You can no longer hear Stephen's voice. Gloria is nowhere to be seen. You feel colder. The bugs are no fun to play with. You'll be sitting here for a long time, completely alone. Nobody checks on you. Did they forget about you? Did they abandon you? Wah, kita ditinggalin sama kakak-kakak kita nih. Parah, parah. Oke, pilihannya kita nangis, menemukan jalan pulang sendiri, atau duduk dan menunggu. Cari jalan sendiri dong. Find your way home. You get up and your feet are swaying a little bit. Carefully you take a first step, then lose your balance and plop down on the ground again. but you are determined. You get up again and keep walking in the direction Gloria went. You walk out the bushes and fire toward the wall of the house, and then the most tender and gentle hand in the wall, the whole world, embrace you and pick you up. Mother has found you. There you are. She pats you on the head. Your brother and sister stand behind her, clearly feeling guilty. Gloria is in tears. Stefan is starting at his feet. You hug mother tightly. She is here now. Determinasinya naik nih. Dari kecil harus mandiri dong. Oh, ini masih masa kecil. Berarti ini apa? Aduh, nama judulnya Lito. Ini game The Life and Suffering Brante ini berarti dia dari kecil sampai nanti dia remaja, pemuda, dewasa, dewasa, tua. Berarti perjalanan yang panjang juga ya nih. Keren, mantap, mantap. Jadi dia sekarang tahun 1120 nih, dia masih masa kecilnya dia nih. Oke, tapi mungkin sampai segini dulu teman-teman, guys, saudara-saudara, bro-bro. Gameplay dari game The Life and Suffering of Sir Brante. Ini game menarik, jadi ya sampai segini dulu game Life and Suffering of Sir Brante. Kita ketemu lagi di gameplay selanjutnya. Oke, terima kasih.